Now we want to welcome the Cutting Crew. They have gained a lot of attention the past few months, and it's definitely deserved. Broadcast is an impressive debut demonstrating the band's wide range, and Rockline welcomes from Cutting Crew, Kevin McMichael. Kevin, welcome to the show.
Hi, thank you.
Nice to have you here, and also with you is Martin Beadle. Martin, welcome to Rockline.
Hi, how you doing?
Good, very good. Your vocalist and songwriter, Nick Van Eed, is that the way to pronounce his name? Is it
That's
Van
correct.
Eed?
That's it,
had
yeah.
Had intended to come tonight, and he had a personal situation to take care of.
Yeah, unfortunately, he had to fly back a couple of days ago, so well, I'll see him like later on this week, and I'll just say hello to him from
Give
everybody.
Give him our best, yeah, definitely. Now, I guess, Kevin, that you and Nick actually started the band, and how did it come together, and what led to the beginning of Cutting Crew?
It was a very strange sort of turn of events. I was playing up in Canada, which is where I'm from originally. And some clairvoyant agent put my band and his band on the same bill together. And so we had a chance to watch each other working for about 2 months. And during the course of that, we became good friends. And we both sort of found out that we were frustrated with what we were actually doing with our respective bands. And went out one night, had too much to drink, and said, yeah, let's put together a band that will conquer the world.
And it's always that way, isn't it? It's written in stone somewhere.
Yeah. And God, it's happening. Yeah.
What part of Canada are you from? Since
we're I'm from Halifax on the East Coast.
From Halifax, the East Coast.
Yeah.
And Martin, how did you become involved in the band?
I was playing in a pub in London one night, and I came across Colin Farley, the bass player.
Mm-hmm.
And he was a mutual friend of Nick and Kevin's, and he introduced me to Nick and Kevin. And the next thing I knew, I was doing an audition for the band. And that was it, more or less, really.
Well, yeah, was it. I mean, to put it all in perspective, we were holding auditions. We'd done auditions like for a couple of weeks, and Martin came along, and he was ever so polite. I mean, we found out that he had just been he just finished doing 3 years on the QE2, the cruise ship, right?
Ah, and, playing the lounges and, in
and
the
then
ship.
This, and this guy comes in a cardigan sweater, going, "Where should I put the drums, chaps?
You know,
this is going to be over in a minute." You know. And so we did a turn. We ran through, and it sounded like somebody unleashed six drummers in the room at the same time.
Right.
It was like all those years of frustration and everything like all came out at once, and so we just went, he's on.
Right. Well, the band has already had a number one song in most countries, top five in most others, and here it is right now, I Just Died in Your Arms Tonight on Rockline.
Many times, oh, I'm dying in your arms tonight. It must have been
From Broadcast, the debut album by Cutting Crew, I Just Died in Your Arms Tonight. We'll return with Kevin and Martin in just one moment. We're waiting for your call, toll-free from anywhere in North America. Only one number for the one and only Rock Line. It's 1-800-344-ROCK. We're live. Call now. Honda Scooters wants you and... Again, welcome back to Rockline. I'm Bob Coburn. We're with Kevin and Martin from Cutting Crew. And if you haven't had a chance to hear more of the Cutting Crew album besides I Just Died in Your Arms Tonight, we will do exactly that for you this evening. We're going to play a couple more songs and take some calls, too, like this one from Orlando, Florida. It's Gene listening to WDIZ. Gene, you're on the Rockline with Cutting Crew.
Hi, Gene.
How are you doing tonight?
Hello?
Hello, how are you doing?
Fine. How are you doing?
I really love the song I Just Died in Your Arms Tonight. I want to know what inspired that song.
Oh, maybe I could take that because... When I first met Nick, he was going through a bit of a breakup with his lady, and he wasn't the happiest of guys in the world. And after about a two-year breakup with this girl, they finally get back together one night. I remember saying to myself, I wonder what's going to happen here, you know, this could be real fireworks. And as it happened, it was, and he said to me the next day, he said, I just died in her arms last night. It was, and then he sort of turned around and said, hey, that's a great song title. And he went away and he wrote this song, then I helped him put it all together, and voila. And he's still with that lady. They made that reconciliation, and he's still with her, so it's a very true song.
They worked it out. That's amazing. I wonder how many people have said, boy, what a great song title, and then nothing ever happens. It's the end of it.
That's really,
I believe he wrote that song in a day, isn't that right, Kevin?
That's right. It all came together in a day, in you know, sort of the rough form, and then I sort of dissected it and helped him put it back together again to make a record out of it, and it was very quick.
Congratulations on this ongoing number one in Canada, by the way. And thank you, Gene, for your call. We're going to talk to Michelle now in West Palm Beach, Florida, listening to WSHE in Miami. Michelle, you're on the show with us now.
Hi, guys.
Hi. Hello. Yeah.
I was wondering, have you made any plans yet to tour with anyone in particular?
Yeah.
And how were you chosen to tour with them, or was it the other way around?
Well, you know, it's a funny old world. 6 months ago, when we had done a British tour and when we had done a European tour and so on, we had all that under our belts. We still could get arrested in America. Nobody wanted to know about us. But having a number one record sort of changed that, and we had everybody from David Bowie like on down phoning us up. And so we decided to do some dates with Huey Lewis and the News. We'll be here on the 12th and 13th.
Here being Southern California.
Costa Mesa. And then we go to Japan for 2 weeks, where we'll be headlining in our own right. And later on in July, Michelle, you can come see us all over America. We're going to be going up with Starship, and we'll be going from mid-July right through to September, and we'll be going all over the country.
That's a great tour to land and a tremendous double bill with Starship and Cutting Crew. That's one definitely worth seeing. I have some other dates here. New Orleans on June 4th, the 5th in Houston, Texas, the 6th San Antonio, Arlington, Texas, between Dallas and Fort Worth, and the 7th in Norman, Oklahoma, right outside Oklahoma City, and the 10th. And those are with the Bengals.
That's right. Yeah.
And Michelle, thank you for your call. Call again, please. Promise to play some rock and roll by Cutting Crew from their album, which is titled Broadcast. And we're going to listen to another song now. This is a really good one. One for the Mockingbird. Cutting Crew on Rockline.
Not to let the hurdles stop my energy.
Nice piece of work by Cutting Crew. I'm Bob Coburn. You're listening to Rockline right now. That is the brand new single by Cutting Crew, One for the Mockingbird. And some nice guitar work on that, Kevin. Some really good
Thank you very much, Bob.
Let's talk to Stephanie now in North Bay, Ontario. She's listening to 600 CFCH. Hi, Stephanie.
Hi.
Hello, Stephanie.
Hello there.
A Canadian. Lovely.
As Kevin is. What's your question tonight, Stephanie?
Well, I would like to know, with Kevin being from Canada, do you guys feel that there's much of a Canadian flavor to your music? Or more of a British style.
That's funny, because we get asked this question all the time, you know, whether it's a British feel and whether it's Canadian and whether it's an American feel. And my only answer is it's sort of a mid-Atlantic feel, because Nick, having lived in Canada, he lived in Canada for 3 years, and of course I was brought up in Canada, and we have influences from both sides, obviously. I think because the majority of the band is British, it's weighted in the European side of things, but it's lovely that we have these influences from both sides, and we seem to have an appeal like both in Europe and America, so it's not for me to judge that. If you like the music, then apparently it's working.
The international band, Cutting Crew.
Really,
there you go,
yeah.
Stephanie. Thanks for being on with us tonight. It's Sheila's turn. She's in Summers, Connecticut, listening to 106 HCN in Hartford. Welcome to the Rockline, Sheila.
Thanks, Bob. Hi, Kevin. Hi, Martin.
Hi.
Hello.
First of all, I'd like to congratulate you guys on a great album, and I just wanted to know, how do you feel about being compared to other artists, and do you feel that's going to help or hurt your career?
Go ahead there, Martin. You can take
that
one.
That's an interesting question. I don't know. I tend to think when I listen to albums by other artists that each performer, each artist has something different to offer musically. I mean, when I listen to different bands and different albums, I listen to them for different qualities in the music. So that doesn't bother me too much when, you know, people compare me to other artists.
Yeah, I mean, that's sort of a double-edged sword, because sometimes people will try to put you down by saying, oh, this is going to be a new Duran Duran or something, right? Which is obviously not what we want, because we're very serious about what we're doing. It is hard sometimes. Like the press, I think, are one side of the coin, and the people that actually go out and buy records are the other side of the coin. So I think in this country anyway, like, we've had a very good reception. Obviously we've sold a lot of records, and it's been very good to us over here. I could mention a few publications in Britain that might think differently, but
quite a few publications in Britain, in fact, who might think differently, but.
Well, I find that the press looks for something different than the audience does. They're after different things. The audience is basically after entertainment. The press is after
fashion and trends, maybe.
Yeah, fashion trends, or some what they consider to be relevant, I guess. Sheila, thank you for your call, your question, definitely. We appreciate you being on tonight. We'll take a brief time out. We'll return with Kevin and Martin from Cutting Crew in just a moment. More rock and roll, more telephone time. Call us toll free from anywhere in North America. It's 1-800-344-ROCK.
Never take the easy road. I ain't no mama's boy.
Once again, welcome back to Rockline. I'm Bob Coburn. We're with Kevin and Martin from Cutting Crew. Time for some more rock and roll by the band now. This one is called Any Color on Rockline. Any Color by Cutting Crew. That song is currently the single in Europe for the band right now. And Kevin, we were talking off mic. You didn't tell me the story, but you said there's something special about that song.
Well, there is, because that's a song for my daughter, Cadence, and it's all about impossible dreams. There was a period I went through about 3 years where I didn't know what was up and what was down in Britain, but I still had to keep writing home and saying it's all going to work out all right, and that's what that song's all about.
Let's talk to Mike now. Mike is in Pocahontas, Arkansas, listening to 103 FM in Memphis, Tennessee. Mike, you're on the show.
Hi. I was just wondering how you guys came up with the name Cutting Crew.
Everybody asked that question, Cutting Crew. And that there are some funny stories attached to that, because it was long before Dougie Fresh Crew and all this, and there was a point where you could find Cutting Crew, like, racked in the back of the record store with all the hip-hop records, right? Because Nick and I came up with this name a long time ago. And really, to be quite honest with you, it came from a British music publication where they were referring to a band as that old Cutting Crew, such and such, has gone into the studio and like to make their 12th album.
It was Queen, wasn't it?
I think it was Queen or somebody, yeah. And I just liked the phrase, and I remember we wrote it down, and when it came to the short list of band names, then that's what we used.
Wow, that's a great story. So many other images come to mind. That's not one of them, but that's
yeah,
the real story.
But that is the truth.
Lots of stories about that one.
Yeah. There you go, Mike. Thank you for asking that question. And thanks to everybody for listening and for calling tonight. You can write to us, if you wish, at P.O. Box 4383, Hollywood, California, 90078. Next week, it's a hot double bill with Warren Zevon as we world premiere some music from his forthcoming album, Sentimental Hygiene. Plus, the outspoken Ozzy Osbourne will be on with Warren next week. Then coming soon, Little Steven and Frozen Ghost in a double bill, followed by Starship. And Cutting Crew, of course, will be out on tour with them sometime beginning in July. Also, Sammy Hagar is scheduled to appear, as well as The Doors and a whole lot more, as Rockline sizzles into summer 87. Thanks to Stu Jacobs and Brian McGill tonight for their special help. Also to Stevie Ray Vaughan and, of course, to Martin Beadle and Kevin McMichael from Cutting Crew. Nice to meet you both. Thanks for a great record.
Thank you. It's been a great pleasure.
It's been a real pleasure having you here. Come back again. I look forward to seeing you in concert as well. I'm BC, and I'll be seeing you in a week.